This is the second part to highlight the July 2009 video, and this time it's going to be a lot shorter than the last video because there's only about 4 games to talk about, all of which are just downloadable games. And the first game I want to talk about was released on July 22nd on Xbox Live Arcade, and you can see in the footage is Splosion Man. And what makes this game really unique is it's a 2D platformer with one simple, you know, gimmick where you can triple jump by making the guy explode. So that's a really simple concept, but what's really awesome here isn't like the level design, how it's always just fast-paced. It keeps you moving, exploding to the next point. There's a really fast pace to the action. So while you kind of have to think about little puzzles that you go on, you know, different kind of barrels that you explode on give you different kind of effects. So there's a little quick thinking there, but the pacing of the game moves so fast that you're just pressing buttons and you're just seeing things go. And what's really awesome about this short little game, it's been said that, you know, it's not only just fun, but it's just the cartoony character and the humor. You know, Xbox 360, you know, he never had a mascot character, and this Splosion Man character definitely feels like he can be a mascot or, you know, platforming icon. So there's really good humor, and it also comes packaged with everything. You know, there's multiplayer, there's co-op, there's competitive multiplayer online and offline. So it's a full package for what you get. It's a great downloadable title for 360 fans. On the PlayStation Network on July 23rd, Shatter was released for $7.99, and so that's a really cool game to get too. It looks like a simple game. It just, you know, you just control a little platform where balls bounce off and you destroy blocks with the ball bouncing. So it's a physics-based game in that regard, and it's been a simplistic style of game. I mean, Breakout came out long time ago. It's very simple, very arcade structure. But what makes Shatter so unique is not just in the like amazing, like trippy music that you can listen to for a long time, and not only also the 3D visuals that really look good, but it really takes this whole physics-based gameplay to a different kind of level where even winds can be affected. So you use winds and you could control the ball's trajectory. There's boss fights, there's blocks that, you know, behave in a certain way. You know, certain blocks and tiles can be loosened and tilted, and, you know, there's all kinds of very puzzle aspects to this, you know, arcade. You normally just expect a really, you know, simplistic arcade game, but Shatter has a lot of interesting puzzle elements to it. You know, it's short, but it's unique, it's fresh, and it's fun, just like many of the games to PlayStation Network. And it's cheap. Unlike many other downloadable games, this game is only $7.99. So for that price, it's really great. Just a really fun game, and even the soundtrack for this game is really great. So even as you play, you're listening to this awesome, you know, kind of 80s feel with the modern twist to the music. And so it's a really great PlayStation Network game to look out for. Another great PSN game came out a week later on July 30th, and this one has been hyped for a very long time. And that's Fat Princess, where, you know, you have these 2D characters and running around in this, you know, one huge map or whatever. There's like different classes to choose from. I believe there's 5 classes, and using these classes, it's like a capture the flag kind of multiplayer matches. But instead of a normal typical capture the flag is a princess that you feed with cake. And the bigger and the fatter she gets, the harder she is to carry. So it requires a lot of teamwork. There is a lot of teamwork, especially with the classes. And the classes are really balanced in a way that anytime during the game, you always have to be doing certain stuff. The workers have to be collecting and, you know, collecting wood and stone to make stuff, to make towers that will defend. You know, the priest needs to heal, the warrior needs to keep attacking. And all these classes, the more you play with them, they actually have an unlockable secondary ability to get as they go. And these really enhance and just refine the experience. And the multiplayer matches, they're so unique and in-depth that it's been said that if there's 2 opposing teams and both teams are really good and they know what they're doing, the match can last for up to like 45 minutes, an hour or something, because on the Rescue the Princess mode, there isn't a time limit or a timer that goes down. So really, this has been one big criticism, that the match can last way too long. And you know, if you just want to pick up and play the game casually for a little while, that's kind of hard because it's so involving and in-depth. It's a really deep, fun multiplayer game, even with this quirky little cartoony graphics. But you know, there is blood that gets splattered when you kill people, so it's not really that kiddish, but it's really fun. There's also bot support, so if you just want to play and practice for a while by yourself, there's that, although this game is really geared towards multiplayer. It's a little bit on the expensive side. It's 15 bucks compared to other PlayStation Network games, which usually sell for 10 bucks. So, but it's been hyped really a lot, and it just requires a lot of great teamwork. There's a lot of fun to be had, and there's a great amount of balance. I guess the only kind of the bad, and there's a lot of content, there's a lot of modes and stuff. The only other thing that's been really been kind of bugging or complain-worthy is it's been said that there's connection problems. But that's been said to be, it's going to be solved through a later patch somewhere down the road. So those who want a stable or really want to make sure that it's safe to buy this game, maybe you should wait a bit longer until the patch comes out and see what everyone else thinks. But for now, I mean, for multiplayer action on PlayStation Network, Fat Princess is really probably a really good title to look and buy. The very last game I wanted to talk about in this video was released also on July 30th for the PC, and that's Bookwork Adventures 2. It's really interesting in that it's just a word game, but it has been fitted into like an RPG story adventure. So whenever you unjumble words, which is really what you need to do, you know, you unjumble tiles and words, you make an attack, and the attack, depending on how long the word, the longer the word is, the more powerful the attack. And this kind of mechanic, along with some other mechanics like item management and whatnot, is implemented into a story structure. There's three chapters to complete in this game, each with 10 levels. So this game is fairly lengthy. I mean, compared to all the other games that I've been speaking about at this point, which have all been downloadable games except for Little King's Story, this is a fairly lengthy game, so you'll kill a lot of hours with this game, and it's just really involving. The word gameplay has been said to be fun, the graphics are charming and cute, really just for an adventure game where you're just using words to play, it doesn't really get better than this, you know. So that's pretty much all the games I have for this month, for July 2009. What's interesting to note here is that out of all the games that I talked about, only one game, Little King's Story, is not a downloadable game for, you know, PSN, Xbox Live Arcade, Steam, or WiiWare. It's just interesting to see, you know, it's the beginning of quarter 3, July, you don't really see a big name game come out, and, you know, they're focusing on the quality of downloadable games, and I think that's great. So for people who don't have the hurdles to, you know, download games on online marketplace, this was a great month for that. For people into retail games, I guess we're gonna have to wait a little bit longer. August is looking better, and holiday seasons are really